Hey everyone, this is Noah coming at you with another QuickNode tutorial. In this one, I'm going to show you how to set up a really simple demo project in Hardhat. And to do that, we'll go ahead and start off in the terminal. So in your terminal, you'll want to have whatever folder that you're in. And with Hardhat installed, you can go to the Hardhat installation in the docs to see how it gets installed. It's just a global installation like any other JavaScript package. So after that, you're going to npx hardhat init, and this is going to initialize your project. You can have a couple of different options here. Just for the sake of this demo, I'm just going to do this sample project, and then it's going to ask you for the project root. The default, if you just hit enter, will be in whatever directory that you're in. So for me, I don't actually want to be in this dev. I want to be in a new project directory, and we'll just call that Hardhat video. And we don't need to get ignore for this. And boom, you can see we've got a project that's been created. So the first thing that you'll want to check out is the hardhatconfig.js file. And this is where you can see how Hardhat initializes itself and configures itself for all of your different tasks and needs. For example, you could change your different solidity file or change which network that you're deploying to. Hardhat comes with a default local test network that it will spin up for you, but you could also deploy to popular test nets like Robson or Coven, for example, and you would do that in this module exports file. We won't be going through that in this tutorial, but just note that it is available to you and you can find it in the Hardhat documentation. So we've got three different folders here. The first one is going to be a greeter.sol file. And in this one, you can see it's just a greeter contract. Its constructor takes a string and called greeting, and it just says that we are deploying a greeter with this particular greeting, whatever you pass in to the constructor. And it also has a read and a set function. So greet will just return whatever greeting you initialized it with, and set greeting will change that greeting. So if you set greeting and then you call this greet function, it will return whatever you previously passed to the set greeting function. So that's the first one. The next one is the scripts folder. Scripts is where you can put any kind of JavaScript folder, and you just import or require the HRE is the Hardhat runtime environment, and this allows you to interact with that local test network straight from a JavaScript file, and it also allows you to get into the console that Hardhat provides for you, and we'll get into that in just a moment. The only other thing that I'll go through really quickly is just the test file. This will import this greeter.sol file and will do whatever test that you have in this case. In this case, we are using this contract factory, and we're pretending that we're deploying a contract, and we're saying, okay, so we pass this to the constructor. So we expect whenever we call greet, we expect it to return this hello world that we passed to the constructor previously. And then you can see if we use this greeter.setGreeting function that we looked at earlier right here, that's just this setGreeting function. If we go over here and we set it to hola mundo, and then we use the greet function again, we expect it to equal hola mundo. So to get a less conceptual understanding and a more in-depth understanding, let's go ahead and pop open the CLI. For this, the first thing that you'll want to do is run the command npx hardhat node. And what this is going to do, it's going to spin up that environment, this kind of local Ethereum testnet that's just running on your computer that I was talking about. And this will show you all of the, it funds you with 20 different keys or 20 different accounts, each with their relevant private key, and it gives them 10,000 Ethereum each. Be sure that if you are deploying this to the mainnet, because you can use Hardhat to deploy contracts to the mainnet, that you do not use any of these, because this is the same every single time that you generate it. It is the same account with the same private key. So there are bots that are watching all of these accounts waiting for you to accidentally send funds to these accounts, and it will automatically siphon those funds and do something with it. So you want to make sure that you are never using these in a production environment. This is only for testing purposes. And so with that, go ahead and running, we can pop open a new terminal. And so what we'll run first is, now that we've got the node running, we can actually run these scripts that you see. So for example, the sample script that they started us off with, you can see we can run that by using npx hardhat run. And we will just do the network flag. And for network, we're going to call the localhost. And so if you had a different network configured, that would be in this hardhat config file under the module exports. You would do dash dash network and then space ropsten, for example, whatever you named the network in here, it would show up as that. But for this one, localhost could just configures right out of the box integrated with this runtime that is going right now. And to do that, so we'll deploy localhost. And what do we want to run on the localhost? We want to do scripts slash sample script .js. And you can see, since we hadn't compiled our Solidity file before, it went ahead and compiled that. It finished compiling, and then it told us, cool, the greeter is deployed to this function. And if we actually go into the sample script, you can see exactly what happened there. So we got the contract factory, this hre.ethers. Ethers is a popular JavaScript library, and Hardhat has created their own ethers. They forked ethers and have it directly in their Hardhat runtime environment so that you can just, without any other kind of configuration and try to get your libraries to work together, you can just use this Hardhat environment. And we can use the ethers method get contract factory. A get contract factory will take, you may be confused here, this greeter is not from the greeter in the file name. It is actually whatever this contract name is. So if I change this contract name, this would fail to run because it isn't pulling from the file. So just a quick kind of misnomer there, as this is going to pull whatever contract is from here. And so after we get the contract, we're going to deploy the contract by using this, calling on this greeter variable, the .deploy function. And .deploy, if we go back to the Solidity file, whenever you deploy a function for the first time, it's going to call the constructor. And so whenever we're calling that constructor, you can see it is a type of string, and it's in memory. This memory is just a Solidity keyword that will make sure that it is always configuring the memory size to fit in the runtime environment. There are certain situations where if you were to pass too large of a string and it didn't have this memory keyword, that could cause some memory errors. So this is just a way to make sure that in the runtime that the EVM environment is making sure that you're allocating enough memory to whatever that you're passing here. And so we're calling hello world. So this dash greeting or underscore greeting is hello world, or hello hardhat, I apologize, is calling hello hardhat onto this. And then we just wait for that to finish deploying. And then we log out here. Cool, we've got the greeter deployed to this address. And so the next step, now that we've got this essentially deployed on our little local testnet, the next thing that we're going to want to do is pull up the hardhat console. To do that, we're going to do npx hardhat console, and again, network localhost, and this will spin up a JavaScript console. So this is essentially just running in that hardhat runtime environment that we have spun up right here on this terminal. And you can see over here that it actually logged out some things for us whenever we deployed the contract. And you can see we deployed a greeter contract, and this contract address we can confirm is the one that I copy pasted earlier. And it shows you how much gas we used. And you can see it's mined the first block on our chain deploying this contract. So if we go back to here, we can kind of confirm that what we see is the case by running a couple of commands. So I'll call this const greeter. And this is going to be the same thing that we used earlier in this sample script. So you'll see we're just going to type in exactly. It's going to be await ethers, because we're already in the hardhat runtime environment, so we don't need to call that first HRE. So we're going to do ethers.get contract factory, and we're going to pass in the greeter. And so you see immediately it says it's undefined, but if we were to type in greeter again, you can see it's this big object. We're going to want to do is call a new variable, and that'll be greeter with a capital G. And what we're going to do for that is we're just going to call our const greeter is equal to greeter, and we want to attach this contract, this address, to our greeter function. And so if we do const greeter and we attach that, we do greeter, you'll see that we actually, let me make this a little bit bigger for y'all. So you can see here, this is another big object, but you can see it's a contract interface. And so we've got the interface, we've got events that it can log, structs, and you'll also see the kind of ethers provider along with the address that we saw that it's deployed to. And it also shows you that we've got that greet and set greeting functions. So if we wanted to take another look at that, we could call something like greeter.greet. We'll call this hello, const hello equals await greeter.greet. And now if we type in hello, you can see we get this hello hardhat. And so you can see we've got the hello hardhat, but to just really show you, we could go back to here, and if we made the console a little bit smaller, so we were able to call this greet function. But what happens if we do set greeting? So if we were to call greeter.setGreeting, and we did what we saw in the test earlier, if we did hola mundo, we've got that. And actually, we want to call, you see that promise, we'll just make sure that we await that. And that will give us the entire thing. So I've got hola mundo. And now if we do greeter.greet, you see, greeter.greet is going to return an anonymous function. Of course, we need to put the parentheses on there. And with that, you can see that we successfully changed it to hola mundo. And if you go over here, you can kind of see the underlying node, what's really happening. So you can see over here on block one, when we deployed it, we said, okay, cool, we deployed it with hello hardhat. And you can see the different contract calls that we called. So each time this is 0xf, that's us from the command line calling this, and then we're calling to this contract address that we pasted in earlier. You can see then we set the greeting. And you'll also notice, since I called this twice without the await, that we actually set it twice. But another thing to note here is that you don't see whenever we had the greet, because that is actually a read-only function. So nothing actually interacted with the chain. We just pulled information off of it. So just like it works on Ethereum, it works the same in the hardhat runtime environment. And with all of that, that will conclude the tutorial. From this, you kind of got a sense of how you can interact with different Solidity contracts and how you can deploy them all running on your own local environment. This is kind of the next step that you would take after deploying something on Remix. If you want to start developing on your local machine, you'll want to use something such as Hardhat.